Good evening. I'm a member of Occupy Now and a representative of Indians of All Tribes Coalition. We've heard a lot about the arguments for fracking has been for convenience. Even the ones against fracking has been for convenience. People are worried about the noise, the traffic, all of this, and they're not worried about the health and safety of the children of Arlington. Let me remind you that yes, maybe when you're thinking of oil and natural gas may be the lesser of two evils, but it is choosing the lesser of two evils that ended up in disaster in Washington, D.C., and it's that same mentality that will end up in disaster in Arlington. Let me remind you, this is something that hasn't been touched on, is that there are large portions of Arlington, members of Unitarian Universalists, members of the neo-pagan community, and members of the Native American community that see the earth as a religious symbol, as a sacred element. And by choosing to destroy and rape what we see as sacred, you are blatantly disregarding our First Amendment right to freedom of religion. Let me remind you that no member of the Native American community, neo-pagan community, or Unitarian Universalist community goes into your community and destroys your churches. We respect your religion. We ask you to do the same for us. We implore you to not allow this to continue. Not only here in Arlington, but do everything you can to prevent fracking and drilling everywhere. But if you don't, if you allow this to pass, then I give you my word. From the Native American community, the Occupy movement, the Unitarian Universalist community, that we will not stand by while you turn your back on the people of Arlington. We will not stand by while you turn your back on the children of Arlington, and we will not allow you to destroy what is sacred to us.
Where is from?
Roosevelt Street.
The address is
1004 Roosevelt Street.
Okay.
Thank you, Pete.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Paul C., and I'm here to politely ask you to reconsider this project and consider alternative sources of energy in which are abundant, self-sufficient, and have become more self-evident in the past decade. Alternative sources in which are actually cleaner for our own planet. Today we have the technological capability to give an abundance of clean energy without drilling or going to war. I understand that alternative sources of energy will allow my children to live in a clean and more sustainable environment. So, you have to ask yourselves, are we really doing our best? Are we really advancing for the better of the human race and our planet? Or are we just going to continue suffering from a disease caused by the current paradigm of the profit incentive? Remember, we have not an energy crisis, nor a political crisis. We have an ignorance crisis. So what the frack should we do? We for a better world.
Two points.
Quality of life, I don't see it. Every time I drive down Matlock,
I see drilling rigs. Every time I drive down Sublet, I see drilling rigs. Every time I drive around Green Oaks, I see drilling rigs. Every time I drive up 360, I see drilling rigs. I see drilling rigs at Hong Kong Market, which probably had to move, because I'm sure they were smart enough business people to know that when that rig went up in their backyard, they were going to lose money and people. So please consider, seriously, sincerely, to vote against this proposition. Even though I don't live in that area, I live in Arlington. I'm a person, and there are people involved in this. I can't even walk down Matlock without the drilling rigs or trucks. I can hardly imagine the people in Bowen who are lucky enough to afford to live in that area, what they're going to feel like when they see those. Thank you.
Bravo.